Previously on Outlaw Paranormal. She said that this cell over here, they thought someone had hung themselves in there or been hung in there.
Jeff and Jimmy, we're with Outlaw Paranormal, and we are going to give you a walking tour of the shrine. Ain't that right?
Oh yes, we go walk through the shrine here.
So we're going to turn you around and show you what's here.
Dax, that's a shrine dog.
This here is the dragon table, which later you will hear about it and the story with it. us is. It's an interesting part of the building, ain't it?
Yes. Maybe if you could your light on top.
It's infrared.
Oh, okay.
But nah, they don't need to see our faces. Yeah, we're ugly.
Yeah, we ugly anyway.
But this here is the cave.
This is one of my favorite spots here. I mean, the cave is a very, very, got a lot of energy in it.
We've been touched. I've been scratched.
I've been pushed. If you don't know the woman, Marge in Charge, look up Marge in Charge on Facebook. She actually come in here and walked through the cave with us when I was pushed over in a cave.
So very, very interesting. And yes, you're getting ready to get a look.
Watch your step.
Man, I felt off balance, sir. So if you feel off balance as soon as you step over.
I did earlier. Should have brought a flashlight with us, I guess.
This is the haunted collection room. This was where I was scratched at.
It's Lisa Marie back there.
We have cold water on this side. And we have hot water down here, but you can't see it because
you hear that growling this back there.
Thought I heard something.
Growling.
I got chills already back here.
This is where we get a lot of activity at.
Yeah, there's something back here. What's that smell?
I don't know. I smell it too. Strong. And there ain't nothing.
But I got goose. I'm just.
Yes. What's that smell though? It's right here.
I can't play. I don't.
It ain't here.
No, it's right here at the step.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't smell it. It's gone. Till I get back here, we're right here. It's gone.
So we ain't even started our investigation yet. We done got growling, and we done got smelling.
It's gone.
The smell.
Come back up here. It's gone. Oh, Lord have mercy.
Right here. Gina.
Yeah.
Come here. We done got a growl.
Yeah, we done been growled at.
Yeah. And see if you get right here and smell that smell.
What'd you do, fart, Jimmy?
No.
No. No. Seriously. No. See if you get any jitters up there.
Yeah, we've been. Do you smell anything? That door made a creeping noise.
I thought you hit it.
No.
That's almost like a burning smell.
Yeah, I don't know what
I can't
smell
place
is.
It. I can smell it, but I can't. It's just so odd. It's.
Yeah, we got a growl sound on this now.
Where?
Right here.
Right here.
Oh, that feel good.
We need to. Let me leave my camera sitting in here. Just in case something happens. Hey.
What's that thumping there?
Something in the closet?
We got this camera set here to get some footage. And then we go get our Jeff's camera to get that intro.
You think we should?
Thank you.
Hey y'all, we are Outlaw Paranormal, and we are here at the Ura Shrine in Bristol, Tennessee. This is one of our other favorite locations that we come to and visit, that's very active. And to tell you a little bit more about where we're at and what we're doing, we have Gina over here.
This place is very interesting, hidden in plain sight in the little town of Bristol, Tennessee. Ura in Japanese means secret, and the shrine has many secrets. There's a lot of different crafts that have been practiced here. They've held Wiccan weddings, they've had Buddhist, Nordics, just anything you can imagine have come here to practice their craft. So there's a lot of activity here. And Japanese believe that everything has an essence, everything has a spirit, and they're called kami. And this shrine was built for the kami. So anything good or bad is welcome here.
Well, that paranormal show that was coming out on the TV, they were showing this on TV last night. Oh, there it is.
Must be
out here. Are you live?
No, I'm just reading.
Oh, I bet shit.
You're live if you
want. I thought it did.
You didn't get to see them last time, did you? Yeah.
No.
Oh, right.
Stand up by here.
Every night. Is anybody live?
Oh, I am. This is one of my favorite spots here at the shrine, the bridgeway. I have always been drawn to this spot right here. It's a very beautiful spot here at the shrine. This is actually the first portal here at the shrine. This portal was built to protect the other world from us. When you're up on this bridge, you are not on the ground. Are you not in the air? You in between.
What we have here is something that is incredibly special. These are the only albino bamboo plants that are in existence. And normally these plants, they have no chlorophyll, so they're totally white or kind of a cream color, and normally they wouldn't live past about 3 feet tall, but these are actually feeding off the root systems of the other bamboo plants. And as far as we know, with research, these are the only ones in existence anywhere. About 400 years ago in Japan, it is written that there were plants, but there's no pictures to prove this, and they've actually built a shrine where those plants were at the time. So two of these plants have been here for about 4 years, and then they have multiplied in the last 2 years, so we now have four of them. So here in a couple of weeks they will be dead and the leaves will fall off until next year. So we are here at the perfect time. So this is absolutely incredible. If anyone knows of any other plants that are out there, please tell us. We would love to hear about it.
The shrine is a private location, and entrance is by invitation only. But tonight, we invite you to join Outlaw Paranormal as we investigate a location that most people will never get the opportunity to see, the haunted Ura Shrine.
Thank you.
All right. As far as the shrine goes, I guess my favorite place in here is probably the whole shrine. When I come up here, it just overwhelming sense of peace comes by, and just I enjoy it. It's kind of like having all your troubles and your stresses and everything just kind of goes away, and you know, kind of gives you back your peace of mind sense. As far as the paranormal goes, the cave here is probably my favorite location. You can come up here one day and have good. Next time you come in, you can feel the negative. So it's always something different. But it's also the way it's made and built. It's just just a cool place to be. But it keeps you on the edge. The water, when he's got it on and running, which we cut it off so you could hear me talk, but it's just a cool place. I mean, it just, I like it. It's a creepy place to lie, but but this has got to be mine.
The entity that's trapped in the cave. Can you show yourself? Make a noise for us.
Let yourself be shown.
Went to this door, he opened or slammed on the screw system.
Yeah, I don't believe he can do it again. I don't believe he can do it twice. Jeff and Kathy sitting here beside
me. Yeah, I was going to say, Dick's walking around again up there. Careful, bud.
Do something right here. Let me do something right here. Y'all stay right here. Get what you're from. One of you walk up and take my seat. One of y'all walk up and take my seat.
Okay.
See if we can get some stuff started. No, I can cut it off. We got these other two going right now.
Deep in the mountains of East Tennessee sits a little-known gem. Something with a good flavor known only to true backwoodsmen. A place where you can taste true mountain heritage. If you have a love for barbecue and a taste for old-style mountain liquor, then you need to take yourself a road trip to John Boy's Barbecue at 4311 Knoxville Highway. Or give us a call at 423-539-0704. John Boy's Barbecue, a taste of backwoods deliciousness.
And then I set up there, and it was right where it is now. And then I
Remember last time they'd only done it right in the door frame.
I'm trying to get my flat night vision light working here. I'm in here by myself in the doll room. Can you make some noises? Can you, Lisa? Can you giggle for me? All right, no bankies. Jeff and Gina and Kathy and Lori's outside. Y'all can't hear anything I say. Come through the spirit box and say Dave or John. Who is tugging on my shirt right now? You light this K2 up behind me now, ain't you? How many of you are in here? Light it up.
crossroads with the dolls. Can one of y'all make some noise? I'm in here alone. Y'all want to do something? Y'all want to play a game? Why are you in here? Will you say, call one of their names, Gina? Do you want me to get out of the doll room? If you do, say get out. If you need any of my energy, please use it. You are allowed to use any of my energy to communicate with me, to make anything move in here. To communicate with me. You just made that thumping noise. Can you make that thumping noise again? Find a spot to set this at. Some banging noise out there so Jeff and them can hear. There's rock and roll in here. Come on, girl. that you need. Man, I'm going to tell you what. This room in here, the doll room, it's got different items in it. It's got a coconut here beside of me. It's got Lisa Marie in here. It's got a bunch of different items in here. And there's a lot of energy. It's actually in this room. When you walk in this door room with the doors open, you feel a lot of energy. Ooh. Now that was very strong. Can you please make some noises? Will you make some noises for me?
Alright, I'm gonna let somebody else walk in here. Somebody else wanna do this. This right here was the freakiest thing I ever done. When you walk in there, shut the curtains, these curtains right here.
Uh-huh.
I didn't really start feeling nothing until I shut these curtains, and it was a very, very heavy feeling after I shut the curtains. I got the camera set up right there. If you want me to shut the curtains behind you, or if you want to leave them open at first and try it.
All right. Well, let's go ahead.
It felt like closing the coffin.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
See that you have this lit up. Can you make the spike any higher? I see it fluttering. That's gonna play nice. Want to touch my arm? Just let me know that you're here.
permission to touch me, but you can't follow me home.